हेलो, टुडेज टॉपिक इज ओवरलोडिंग मेथड एंड हियर वी टेक अ क्लोजर लुक एट मेथड्स एंड क्लासेस। सो टॉपिक वी कवर इन दिस वीडियो ओवरलोडिंग मेथड्स, ओवरलोडिंग कंस्ट्रक्टर और यूजिंग ऑब्जेक्ट एज पैरामीटर एंड आर्ग्यूमेंट पासिंग पास वैल्यू बाय वैल्यू एंड रेफरेंस रिटर्निंग ऑब्जेक्ट एंड रिकर्शन। रिकर्शन प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन वी ऑलरेडी कवर्ड एंड रिटर्निंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स वी ऑल्सो कवर्ड एंड द प्रोग्राम्स वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोग्राम टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट द मेथड ऑफ ओवरलोडिंग एंड ऑटोमेटिक टाइप कन्वर्शन एंड रिलेटेड प्रोग्राम ऑफ दीज टॉपिक्स एंड एब्स्ट्रैक्ट आर पॉलीमॉर्फिस फाइनल कीवर्ड दीज आर ऑल टॉपिक। If time left, so we will cover these topics also. So let's start. Overloading methods. Overloading methods. So let's take a look of one program. With the help of program, you can better understand. In Java, it is possible to define two or more methods within the same class that share the same name as long as their parameter declaration are different. When this is the case, the methods are said to be overloaded and the process is referred to as method overloading. So method overloading is one of the ways that Java supports polymorphism. If you have never used a language that allows the overloading of methods, then the concept may seem strange at first. But you will see method overloading is one of the Java's most exciting useful features. When an overloaded method is invoked, Java uses the type and or number of argument as its guide to determine which version of overloaded method to actually call. So thus overloaded methods must differ in the type and or number of their parameters. While overloaded methods may have different return types, and the return type alone is insufficient to distinguish two versions of a method. When Java encounters a call to an overloaded method, it simply executes the version of method. So whose parameters match the arguments used in the call. So let's see this program. So here is a class overload demo void test. And here is, we are taking no parameters here. No parameters. And this program is automatic type conversion applied to overloading. Because before that, I run a simple program. So we will see this program. Here is, or in a simple program we use this, but in the automatic we are overload test two integer parameters. Here we are taking two integer parameters in one avoid test, but here and printing both together, but here we are printing one by one. Okay, so here it is the difference in automatic. So overload test for double parameter and this, and here is a main class overload. So this is, so let's go to another topic. And what is the another topic of ours is overloading constructor. So let's go to overload constructor. In addition to overloading normal methods, you can also overload constructor method. In fact, for most real world classes that you create, overload constructor will be the norm, not the exception. To understand why, let's return to the box class developed in this program. So let's see the class box here. let's go back to the project and find out there. So here is the box class, and this is the program where we are using object as parameter. So here is, we are cloning the object, and constructor used when all dimensions specified, and then when no dimensions specified, both are mentioned in this program. So this program consists of two or three topics together. Here is introduced when no dimension specified, then constructor used when cube is created, and here box is extended to include weight. So extend keyword is used here, and this, so class demo box and all this. So this program, we have only been using simple type of parameter, but in this program we are using and initializing the another. So let's go to argument passing, and argument passing for argument passing we have question, example question. There are two ways that the computer language can pass an argument to subroutine. The first way is called by value. This approach copies the value of an argument into the formal parameter of the subroutine. Therefore, changes made to the parameter of subroutine has no effect on the argument. So let's see with the example. So this is the example of pass by value. So here is a public class para test static, and here is we are passing values. So passing values, pass by value means that when you call a method, a copy of the value of each of the actual parameter is passed to the method. You can change the copy inside the method, but this will have no effect on actual parameters. So you can see in the example below. So the values of variable are always primitive and references, never objects. In Java, we can pass a reference of the object to the formal parameter. If any changes to the local object that can take place inside the method will modify the object that was passed to it as argument. Due to this reason, object passing as parameter in Java referred to as passing by reference. In the program given below, here is another program by passing as reference. In the program, class marks is passed to the method set grade, in which instance variable grade of the object passed to assign the sum value. So this reflects that the object itself is modified. So you can go with this program and see the difference. So let's go to increment salary, returning objects. We already discussed about the returning objects. Let's take this topic again.